Hello, welcome to this guide. Let's see all the most important and basic features inside the newest Microsoft Visio Professional 2019. Do not forget to check our YouTube channel and our official website for more tutorials, extras, news, release dates, and giveaways. Microsoft Visio is a professional product used to build flowcharts, diagrams, schematics, and also custom drawings for academic and business environment in order to explain and represent content inside drawings. In this video, we get a general and complete overview on how to use Visio. When opening Visio, its startup page shows up. On the left, you can browse and reopen an existing Visio document. On the right, you can pick any ready template to start with a new drawing. Visio has several ready templates available, from basic flowcharts to layouts and diagrams. To see how to use Visio, let's start from a new empty page by going to Blank Drawing. Choose whether to use the metric or the U.S. unit, and go to Create to open the document in the main Visio workspace. This has the ribbon on top, collecting all the tools and features inside Visio. The Shapes panel on the left with ready shapes available and the drawing page where you drop and edit your objects. Before starting drawing, make sure you set your page first, especially if your work must be exported or printed once finished. Use the Page Setup section under the Design tab to set the page orientation and its size between several standard formats. You can go to More Page Sizes to define a custom one instead. On Backgrounds, you can also add any background or title on the page. Once the page is ready, you can start drawing inside your document. This is made by three main kinds of objects: the shapes, the connectors, and the pieces of text. Shapes are simple objects like rectangles, circles, lines, but also complex ones like motors, buttons, and icons showing topics and representing subjects. The connectors are wires and arrows connecting shapes and showing relationship and dependence between these. Pieces of text are titles and annotations used to name or describe your objects. Let's start with the shapes. To draw shapes on your document, you can either use the Shapes panel on the left or the Drawing Tools inside the Home tab above. The Shapes panel contains several ready templates to use inside collections called Stencils, different in kind and topic. Inside More Shapes, choose the stencil interested, and then drag and drop the template from the list at the bottom to create a copy of such shape in your document. Whereas to create custom drawings, you have to use the drawing tools inside the tool section above. You can drop rectangles, ellipses, lines, arcs, and also freehand drawings by clicking and dragging on your document. You can also use the pencil tool to draw lines, arcs, or circles depending on how you use your cursor. In addition, with the options inside the Draw tab, you can draw freehand traces, especially when using any touch screen. Pay attention that these kinds of drawings can't be customizable as the standard shapes we are going to see. To check your drawings in detail, zoom in and out on your document by holding down the Control key while using your mouse wheel. Visio has several drawing aids to help you at drawing shapes. Under the View tab, you can hide and show rulers, the page grid, and set all snappings and guideline options inside the Snap and Glue panel. Snappings are used to place your cursor directly on grid points, shape contours and vertices when it is close enough. Guidelines are used to draw and align objects through precise directions. You can ignore all these drawing aids by holding down the Alt key. Once the shapes are placed, you can link and connect these together with wires called connectors. Enable the Connector tool and click and drag from any green contour to create a wire from the actual shape to the next one. On other shapes, you can start the connection from defined anchors called connection points, highlighted in green color. You can adjust the connectors by clicking and dragging from their blue nodes and change their link by moving their endpoints. All shapes created with ready templates do include connection points and contours, but all the custom ones made with the drawing tools do not, so it becomes hard to create connections with these unless you create connection points first. To add connection points, select the interested object and enable the connection point tool from the Home tab. At this point, hold down the Control key and click on specific points on the shape or outside it to add a connection point represented in pink color. You can also move these points by clicking and dragging these directly. If these points already hold connectors, these get updated as you move. Once these points are made, you can easily snap to these and add your wire connectors. Now let's see how to manage and edit the shapes and connectors inside your Visio document with the pointer tool inside the Home tab. First of all, select the object interested by clicking on it. This shows several nodes you can use to rotate or scale the object by respecting or not its aspect ratio. To move the object, click and drag it directly. Visio will help you with several green guidelines in order to place and align your object correctly. Remember that you can avoid any snapping or guideline by holding down the Alt key. Whereas, hold down the Shift key to move horizontally or vertically. In case you move any object outside the page margins, this will be automatically extended if the Auto Size option under the Design tab is on. You can cut, copy, and paste a selected object by right-clicking on it. To undo any bad action made inside your document, just use Ctrl and Z. You can also customize freehand drawings by selecting these and enabling the Freeform tool, using the blue nodes and handles to adjust the curves. To adjust the appearance of your objects, you have to use the Shape Style section under the Home tab. Use Fill to add and set the filling color, Line to adjust the line color, style, weight, and endpoints, and Effects to add special effects such as shadows, reflection, bevel, and more. For the complete list of properties and options, right-click on the object and go to Format Shape. You can also use quick templates for the overall document appearance inside the Theme section under the Design tab. In case of wire connectors, you can right-click on these to set them straight or curved, adjusting these just like the freeform drawings. To modify multiple objects together, select all of these first by holding down the Control key and then edit all of these. Text is added to describe or name the several shapes you have built. With the Text tool enabled, click and drag on the document to create a text area which delimits the content you type inside. Then, adjust the text color, font, size, style, and distribution under the Home tab. These modifications are applied on the whole text unless you select just a piece of it. The piece of text created can be moved, scaled, or rotated independently, as seen for other objects before. You can also create pieces of text linked to shapes that follow the object in case you move or edit it. With the pointer tool enabled, double-click on an object to add text to it and use its yellow node to place it correctly. Once your custom shapes are finished, you can save and collect these into your own stencils on the left in order to reuse them in other Visio documents. To create a new stencil, go to More Shapes and then to New Stencil. Then select one or multiple objects and drag these into the new stencil on the left. Once imported, you can right-click on the shapes or on the stencil to rename and save these. Inside Visio, you can also import extra objects such as pictures, charts, and CAD drawings with the tools inside the Insert tab. Use Pictures to browse and import a picture. You can move, scale, and edit it just like standard shapes. You can also use the Format tab above to correct the photo brightness and contrast. Add any outline with line, or crop the picture with the Crop tool. Use Chart to import charts inside your document. You can fully edit and customize these if you have Microsoft Excel installed. Check out our video tutorial to discover how to edit charts with Microsoft Excel. Finally, let's see how to save and export your work from Visio. To save your document, go to File, and then to Save As. Choose where to save and also the format to use. VSDX saves your work as a Visio document in order to open and edit your drawings in the future. PNG or JPEG exports your whole document as a picture rendered in pixels. PDF saves all in a PDF document ready to be shared. Make sure not to have any object selected while saving, or all the rest of your document won't be taken into account. In addition, if you go to the Design tab and then to Fit to Drawing, you can resize your page to the content of your document. This is very good since it optimizes the quality and the details of your drawings in case you do not have to respect the standard page layouts. To print your document, go to File and then to Print. On the left side, you can set all the print options, such as Pages, Orientation, and Page Size, while checking the preview on the right side. As you can see, no visual aids such as guidelines or grids are printed. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to check our channel to get more and free video tutorials dedicated to Microsoft Office 2019.